Nice job with those defenses. I've got nothing else I need right now. I think Preston may want to chat, though.
Watching me sleep?
I should have done more.
All right, in this episode, I'm going to change it up a little bit. I actually liked the fact of recording over the voice. Just it's much easier in Sony Vegas. Of course, you guys get the better audio options in the actual gameplay. Plus, I can fast forward and not have to worry about it. But anyway, this one, I'm going to, after I screw around in Sanctuary here for a minute or two, it actually looks like about three, I'm going to be heading over towards Ten Pines so I can actually initiate the Corvega plant. And going into Corvega, around Lexington and all that kind of area, I'm kind of making my way around Lexington, but I'm actually going to be shooting with using the power armor this time, just because of the simple fact of carry weight and the extra ammo. Had a couple fusion cores, so I figured, okay, I can make that without a problem.
If you work, you eat. It's as simple as that.
At this point, I was thinking about... I was thinking about trying
to
see if I
can
make some vegetable starch to make some more adhesive, but... The meat fruit hasn't quite grown as much as I wanted to so far, so. No, you're too low level. Quit trying. Like, well, maybe I ought to bring some extra fees before, so...
Got work to do. Can't talk now.
Wasn't trying to. When you watch them run fast forward. I didn't feel like doing this mission here. For one, obviously, I didn't feel like getting out of the power armor. Two, if you do this mission, then it clears out the excavation site, and then the raiders take over. And I didn't want to deal with that yet, so I figured I'd save it for a little bit later. And I left this non-fast-forwarded through this part right here just because, I did skip a little bit right there. But I figured, well, while I'm here, there is a bed there, and I decide to temporarily get out of the power armor.
Sweet.
Do a quick save spot, and then continue on. No point. Sleep bag. Obviously can't do that in power armor. Okay, back to fast forward. Up here, got a pretty nice find. Encountered a legendary, just one, legendary rat stag. So I figured I'd go ahead and slow it down so you guys can see this. Had a really nice weapon on, so I decided to keep it. Figured I'd use a crit. Hit with flying. It's not bad. It's better than the one I have currently. Yeah, fast forward a little bit more here. That's when I encountered the woman selling the bra. At first I figured, why do I want it? But I do, as I understand it, I think you can get a... If you have a Brahmin at your settlement, you can actually get a...
Hey, I got a question for
fertilizer.
I can sell you a Brahmin.
Inside your workshop.
As is, of course. But quality is guaranteed.
And I'm pretty sure all she did was just take it from the field down there at the beginning of the tracks. Because a little bit later on, I encountered like three of them just roaming around there openly. But... I don't know of a way to bring him back to your settlement without using things like animal.
Does this Brahmin really belong to you?
What do you think? It's stolen or something?
Look at her eyes. She's all drugged out.
Of course she's mine. Could be yours too, for a very reasonable price.
Sure, I'll take her.
Oh, great, great. Just tell me where you want me to send her, and she's all yours.
Let's be getting on the jet.
Good doing business with
you,
sister.
It's funny because she didn't even
take
the Brahmin and just turns around and walks away to the settlement. Must be pretty smart Brahmin. Then out of nowhere, this dog starts to attack her. I have no idea why. It's like it appeared behind me. Must be a scripted event. I realize it's pointless using bats. She's like a level or two above me, so she could easily handle the dog herself anyway.
I'll have more products soon. Don't worry.
Oh yeah, there's three more down there by the track. Do some fast forwarding so I get to 10 pines.
What do you want? We don't need any more trouble around here.
Take it easy. I'm with the Minutemen. I'm here to help.
You're with the Minutemen? I didn't really think you fellas still existed. We sent word with one of them passing traitors. But honestly, I never expected anything to come of it. Most people don't put much stock.
We're rebuilding the Minutemen from the...
Glad to hear it. No question that things have been worse since the Minutemen fell down. There's a raider gang that's been giving us trouble for weeks. Stealing food and supplies. Threatening to kill us all if we don't... We know where they're coming from, but we can't go up against a gang like that.
Don't worry. I'll take care of those raiders for you.
Thanks, friend.
Even though it says you can't do it, you still drink. At this point, I figure I'll go ahead and take out these rushers real quick. And of course, I almost messed, not really all messed it up, but it's like really stupid roach. Completely missed this one. Like, I don't know if I'm fine. And in this episode, I don't actually make it into Corvega, but I run into some raiders along the way. So I figured I'd go ahead and keep that in, because it's a pretty good encounter. And I figure the episode's gone on long enough, so at that point I'm going to end this video at the Corvega door, and then the Corvega plant will be the next episode. At this point coming up, I was trying to decide, do I want to kill these mole rats in the junkyard? It's kind of a pain in the butt. But there was a settler over there fighting them. I figured, you know what? That's extra food, so I figured I'd go ahead and do it. Settler, really. I was attacked by quite a few of them. Just trying to make sure I'm not prepared.
Commonwealth justice for you. Made it. This time. Thought I saw something.
After chewing on your ass.
Hi.
I try to talk to her because I then realize, okay, there's more to kill. Because one of these two settlers, if you help them out, I think it only happens if both settlers are there. Let's usually travel in twos, but after this fight, I try to get her to go back to Sanctuary, but dialogue wouldn't come up for some reason. Choice. She does give me caps, though.
Huh? Yes.
Like, okay. I guess I have to clear the ones out inside the tunnel also. Pick up all that free food. So I'll head in here, and I think there's about 4 or 5 more. Do I want to do it? I want to. started to realize, because I was going to pick up some of these mods or some of these weapons so that I could use some of the mods off of them, but started to realize that taking the mods off actually uses adhesive, so I was like, yeah.
Thanks for the help.
That's where she gives me the cap.
Thanks for the help.
Come on, come back to my settlement. But I wouldn't bring up the dialogue for it. Yeah, let's fast forward into the raider encounter here. Actually, I think I encounter some stupid, No, this is the raiders. Figure for sure somebody's gonna come running out after me. There is another raider in there, but I think with the main caution that I'm getting right now is from a turret. As you'll hear it here in a second. And I was not about ready to go into Lexington proper, just because, you know, some ghouls in there, they should be relatively easy to take out, but there's also a power armored raider in there, which most of you, I'm pretty sure, already know, that has a fat man, and I figured that just spelled ultimate doom right there, so... Still hungry? Then again, I guess chunks aren't exactly a meal, so... Well, if there's cans coming down, there's obviously another raider in here, so... Like, oh, there she is. With a turret. She's about ready to turn around and see me, so... Three cans. I don't normally use the power armor in normal play, just because I find the HUD to be a bit bulky, even though it's transparent. I don't know, it just feels like you're enclosed too much. And it's kind of funny how they made it, even though how much bigger you are, you can still get through any obstacle that you would normally get to in a normal without using it. This is where I encountered the stupid mosquitoes being stuck inside the ground. I guess some bug with the engine. I get one of them to come out, but the other one's stuck, so I was like, yeah, screw it. Now it's there, because I can see the wing moving. it made this sound, so I was like, okay, well. Figured I wanted to go in there and get the free Brahmin meat, so maybe I can draw them out. There's one of them. Tried to get the other one out, but it wouldn't come out, so just continued on my way. Help, there's a dead Brahmin on me. I just wasted ammo. This is what I figured. You know what? I'm just gonna draw them out from here. Because otherwise the guys from the top would just keep shooting at me if I went into the front door. I'll take him out, but I draw him out from the bottom. Kind of funny how they still show caution even though they are scared, huh? You can tell they see you because they're shooting at you, your general location. You would think it probably might be panic fire, but you can tell they know where you're at even though it does say caution. It's another weird game mechanic. I wish for sure something would spawn up there on the top, but I guess it's normally a gunner spot for when you're a higher level.
Only a fucking coward hides.
No, in survival, only a smart person hides. Three wasted rounds in bats. That's where in most locations bats is kind of a waste of time unless you have a critical shot built up or if they're really close to you. Obviously I'm guessing, well, at later levels it becomes more apparent that you can use it more often, but these lower levels, the accuracy is so bad. Surprised I got that one. There, hit the concrete. Even though you can tell I wasn't, but. I know there's some rad scorpions up there in the building on the right hand side, but I don't bother going over there. He's trying to run. So at this point I was for sure somebody might have been up here, but at the same time, nobody bothered to come down to shoot at me since I was shooting at those guys, so I kind of figured, maybe not, but I just wanted to make sure. Plus, if there's any extra ammo or anything up here, I figured I'd go ahead and collect it. I realized, okay, there's nobody up here. But I did notice on the side there, I'm like, there's a bed. Didn't think of it right away. I started, okay, I'll just go ahead and make my way into Corvega. This point, I was like, you know what, this is a perfect opportunity. Maybe I ought to go back up there and do a real quick save. This point, I was also changing out the fusion cores because it was starting to get a little low. I still think it's a pretty cool retexture of that outfit. This one I was like, you know what, let's go up there and use a bit. Just in case. Overweight, so I have to move really slowly, but such a short distance, it's not gonna over encumber you, and you will take damage if you're overweight. The last time you take too long to go back, we'll find out later when I was talking to Preston. He gave me a flare right when I was like way overweight, couldn't even, I had to quit talking to him because I didn't want to take any more damage. I'm not sure what I was thinking there, I guess just to drop some extra weight. But that will wrap this episode up. And I'll continue on the next episode. Episode 6 will be the Corvega plant. So, hope to see you all there.